What do you see when you look at me? I'm gonna give you 7 seconds to decide. Minutes 55 seconds. Time to hang it up. We're gonna get into this review in just a second, but before we do, we want to ask for your assistance. Please help us out by hitting that like and subscribe button. Tell a friend about us. In exchange, we'll provide you with this cringy gun meme. Get out of there. Oh,
excuse me, bro. You're excused.
And I'm not your bro.
Hey, we're big fans of the Equalizer movies. Hope you are too. And today we're discussing a firearm of the same name. Now, Smith and Wesson came out with this in hopes of helping some of those folks out there who might be a little recoil adverse or have difficulty manipulating the slide. Overall, it is a internally hammer fired pistol, semi-automatic with a 15+1 capacity. And this one's optics ready. We're going to check it out and let you know what we think coming up. Let's jump into the ergonomics here. Smith set out to make a gun that's gonna be a little bit easier for a wider variety of folks to be able to handle. And this one is gonna definitely appeal to the folks who are adverse to recoil, who are sensitive to recoil. What did they do to accomplish that? A number of things. First off, I'd like to start with the grip. This is a really thin, ovular-shaped grip, and it has a really good texture on it. I mean, that's pretty aggressive, but the shape is nice and rounded, and like I said, it's an oval. When you look at the bottom of the mag, you can really see that shape there too. Now on top of that, you've got a good beaver tail here that is enough to cover the back of my hand, which sometimes tends to fold up and over. And then the reduction of the recoil spring is really nice. It's super easy to rack this slide. It's not difficult at all. Smith did something really cool on top of that. If you look at this size, they included the 15 round mag, but they also have a 13 round mag. And now we're getting into, you know, just barely fitting here, but if you want some options for concealment, this is your next step down. And then they also include a 10 round. I can't get my pinky on with that, but you know, I have 2X hands, so most folks that's gonna be totally applicable to. Moving up to the slide, really good texturing here. The milling on the slide is very aggressive. So if you wanna run it forward up here, if you're not running an optic, you can reach over, grab here, slingshot. Either way, it's so easy to grip it with this texturing and with the reduced action on that slide spring that you're able to rack it with just pinching it just like that. So moving on to the trigger. Trigger's got a nice curved bow and it's in a good place. I feel like I can get as much or as little as I want and it's well placed. So overall the ergonomics are pretty good and should appeal to a pretty wide variety of folks. Moving on to accuracy. I've got a Bushnell RXC 200 mounted on here. We're going to test this out during this process, use it to give us some accurate groups, hopefully, if I do my part. We're at 7 yards. I'm gonna shoot 3 5-shot groups and just see how they group up. Would help if I had enough ammunition. All right, so I didn't have full on 15, But our first five shots were here, and I'm kind of getting used to the trigger. There's definitely a wall that you get to. We'll talk about that in a little bit. And then moving over here, had these four. I absolutely jerked that one. So that one's on me. And then the three left pushed in up here and was able to group them together pretty good. It's got some challenges to it. It's a decent trigger, but we'll talk about that coming up next. So let's talk about that trigger. Got a little bit of travel right there. We hit a wall, pretty well defined, and now I'll go ahead and break the shot. Reset. All the way, almost all the way back out. And then we'll break the shot again. There's a tiny bit of travel after you hit that wall, and then the shot breaks, and then reset is audible and tactile. So one of the issues you might face if you are recoil adverse, or if you have a hard time just manipulating a firearm and some of the more challenging aspects of it, is stuffing mags. Jamming mags is going to be a challenge for some folks. So we're going to start out and load this 15 round magazine. Oof. Okay. I want to say that's 13, and that's what it's showing right here, but it gets kind of tough after that. The spring is really resisting. Thankfully, Smith thought of that. They provide an up Lula in this kit. So we're going to close this off, push down, get that next round in. And frankly, this is why I only had 13 in the last one. I just stuffed it until it felt full. I wasn't actually counting the rounds. And then the last one, and that doesn't take an incredible amount of effort with this tool. It really helps out. Hey, we appreciate you watching this video, but be sure to head over to pewpewtactical.com for all the details in the article. So worth pointing out that the way these mags are designed, I really appreciate the steel body, and you've got the colored follower and the windows here that let you know basically where you're seating. But it takes about everything I have, and I've been described as having rock fingers, to get these last couple rounds in. There's a lot of resistance, and then it kind of breaks through and pushes down, and you're finally able, with some effort, there it goes, to get them in. So obviously the easy answer is to use this to get those last couple rounds in. So I want to point out that this reduced recoil spring has a couple of benefits. One, the recoil itself is very manageable, especially when you think about the ergonomics of the grip. It also makes it a little bit easier to pull back off of lockback. Now, the release up here, the slide stop, whatever you want to call it, it's still pretty tough to compress that, but with just one finger, I can push forward and flick it off like that, and it's ready to go. So I dig that. I'm not saying this is my official influencer t-shirt, but it sure seems like they were inspired by me. And it makes it funny when you look at my face and it looks like I'm the head on top of this tiny Sasquatch body. Moving on to our final thoughts on the Smith & Wesson Equalizer. This is a pretty cool little gun. I dig the fact that they really spent some time thinking about the ergonomics and some of the challenges that don't have the same grip strength or hand size that I do might go through in order to go out and want to buy a handgun. These are barriers to purchase, and it's up to these manufacturers to figure out how to defeat those. So they reduce the power of the recoil spring without compromising any kind of integrity. We had zero malfunctions with this firearm, ran at least two different brands and weights of ammo through it, and didn't have any problems whatsoever. Accuracy is pretty good. I think that the trigger takes a little bit of getting used to. It's certainly not the M&P 2.0, but it's good. And once you practice with it, you can be pretty effective with it. I really like that Smith includes a 15, a 13, and a 10. As far as the magazines go, and the floor plates give you a little bit of extra purchase. I would definitely stick with the 15 and the 13 because once I get down to the 10, it's just too small for me to still continue to have good purchase. Ergonomics are really good. I like the thin grip. I'm not a big fan of grip safeties, but I appreciate that some people might want that. You've got an internal hammer here that, like I said, provided accurate fire and just kept plugging away through everything we dished out. Again, the milling on the slide, really good here. Easy to use, easy for people who maybe don't have giant strong hands, and that's pretty cool. So again, overall, really good deal, and I appreciate that Smith came out with this. Now, talking about price, this is going to be $600 on the Smith & Wesson website, but we are seeing them at online retailers for right around $500, sometimes a little bit less. That's going to do it for us and the Smith & Wesson Equalizer. We hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.